Hey everyone, in this devlog, I'll be getting to work designing, programming, and building a brand new trade system for Lumbermill, a management and factory builder game set deep in the forest. In the last devlog, I created a translation system, which I've actually thrown out of the window this week and rebuilt from the ground up. More on that later in the video, so let's get into it. Over a year ago now, in November 2019, I finished up the first version of the game's trading system. What I came up with then was a structure called the Trading House, which would be randomly constructed somewhere in the world for the player to discover. They would then need to connect the Trading House to the factory using rails, managing up to 4 trades at once. Trade offers came in through the post from different companies, and that was about it. There were a load of problems with this. The 4 trade limit was too restrictive, the Trading House really hard to explain, and the offer and acceptance system half-baked. As trade is a huge part of managing a successful lumber empire, trade was in need of a huge redesign to make things more rewarding and consistently interesting. I spent a few days exploring the trading systems of other games, such as Anno, Civilization, and, of course you guessed it, Farming Simulator, which is unironically great fun by the way, trying to figure out what works best in all of these games. 11 pages of handwritten notes and planning later, I eventually settled on a design I think should hopefully be quite fun. I set up a to-do list on Trello of all the features that need to be added and got to work on the first code for the system, starting with the trade offer generator, company definitions, and deleting the old trading house code, which has sat unused and alone for many months. I created a test company called Testco, giving it some basic data to get started with generating offers. I added the new company to the trade manager and got offers being generated and output as text to the console. Trade offers are based on the player's reputation and have a company, item count, item type, price per unit, and a duration. So with the offers generating, I got to work on the interface for displaying offers. As always, I designed this by hand on paper before laying everything out in Unity. This just makes things so much easier when choosing how to structure things in the game engine. The offer interface will emerge from the left-hand side of the screen and has quite a few different functions, which I'll get into. The company logo for the current offer is always shown nice and big at the top of the offer interface, just to bring a bit more immersion to the system. So, of course, I had to make a test logo for Testco. Yep, that's Comic Sans, and yep, graphic design is my passion. I added that to the interface and I was happy with the dimensions. There's plenty of space for all the information and the logos should add some nice detail. If you have any ideas for company names or wood products they might buy from a mill, let me know in the comments. There are 2 parts to this interface, the trade overview, which lists all trades and offers, and the summary, which displays more detailed information about a particular trade. The interface will slide between them with a nice transition when it's all done. So next, I built out the other side of the interface for listing trades. You'll be able to filter offers, current deals, and completed deals separately to make managing them easier. Offers currently in progress have a pair of progress bars, one for the percentage of goods collected, and the other for how far through the duration you are. As long as the top bar is ahead of the bottom bar, you'll know you're on track to complete on time. With the structure all ready, I created a script for managing the trade window and set up the animation for the interface appearing and disappearing from the side of the screen. While I was at it, I also chose transitions for the animated buttons for accepting, declining, and countering trade offers. That brings us to counter offers. When you receive an offer from a company, you don't necessarily have to accept or decline. When you choose the counter option, you can adjust the price of each item in the deal and the interface will tell you what the chances are of the counter offer being accepted. I thought this could be pretty fun, trying to maximize profit and take some risks while not being too greedy. Some companies might lowball you, so it might be wise to try and increase your earnings. The higher your reputation, the more likely a company is to accept a high offer. As this is key to the trade system, the process of responding to an offer needed to feel satisfying. My solution for this was to design some stamps, inspired by the Soviet border control map, Papers Please, that'll animate onto the interface when you accept, decline, or counter an offer. The first design didn't look great, with lines that were way too thick. I redesigned them, this time with a thin outline edge and a language-independent tick and cross for accepted and declined offers. They looked a lot better, and with a good stamping sound effect, I'm sure this will feel like a nice decisive action for the player. Now, it's all well and good having an interface for trade, but Lumbermill is a factory builder, so I needed to get to work on the construction side of trade. Rails are making their return and will be used for transporting trade goods to the dock. Each trade will be packed up into a box by a trade collector machine, and upon completion, a trolley holding those goods will be dispatched. I ditched the old rail design from early in the game's development, opting for a classic metal rail with wooden sleepers and ballast. It took a while to get all the dimensions right to make things repeat nicely, but I eventually figured out a pattern and, using the conveyor belt object to test, was pretty happy with how they looked in the game. It just needed some grass shadows to ground the design properly. With those added, this is how the basic rail design looked. So I created a Unity object for the new trade rails, set up the trade rail class, and created a bunch of rough placeholder sprites just to make sure all the junctions joined up correctly. I sliced them, added them to the rail object, and they worked nicely. This is just a simple marching squares setup. Unlike conveyors, I'm hoping to animate trolleys to rotate in 3D around corners. In the old system, carts always remained facing the same direction, which doesn't make sense. In the interest of getting the vital stuff done first though, I'll probably be creating the animation in the next devlog. With the corner variations complete, this is how the rails were looking at that point. As you can probably tell, it's been quite an intense few weeks for development. Luckily, I went away last weekend with my parents to Sussex in the south of England to have a bit of a break now we're finally out of lockdown. Explored an old ruined 14th century castle and had a nice rainy walk to the Seven Sisters cliffs. I definitely needed the break, and coming back to the trading system now feels a bit less stressful. Returning to development, I got a comment on my last devlog from fellow indie developer Thin Matrix with advice for some changes I might need to make to the translation system I built. I could fill simple gaps in text using placeholders, however the problem with that is that in languages such as German, word and sentence structure can vary depending on context, meaning certain grammar just wouldn't be possible with the old system. I made it my mission that week to learn as much as possible about the other translation systems out there. After a lot of experimentation with both Unity's built-in localizer and an off-the-shelf solution called i2, neither had the flexibility or ease of use I wanted for dynamic text. So I made my own, called BW Localizer, based on them. The new system allows for rules, such as plurals, to be built into sentences, and metadata such as word gender to be added to text so that choosing the right words in the right context should hopefully generally work. If you're interested, I've put a link in the description if you want to check out the examples and documentation for the system. I'm open to any suggestions you have for how this might be improved for your language, so let me know on Discord if there's anything you'd like added. I haven't decided what languages to support yet, so any suggestions for the system are welcome. So, the next thing to add for trade is a collector machine. I created the class for it, set up the prefab in Unity, and got it connecting to conveyor belts on one side and rails on the other. This will collect items for a particular trade deal from the conveyor belts, pack them up, and dispatch them to the dock when ready. As you can see here, when I choose to accept a trade offer, it prompts me to choose a collector, and once that's done, the offer is accepted and collection can begin. The last thing to do was finish up the trade deal list, adding a temporary button to the deal overview screen to navigate between them. I set up all the public variables to link things in Unity, and this is how that looked when finished. You can filter by deal, current deals, and completed deals. You can also view a trade in more detail by clicking the information button. You can see the progress of the current trade in the control panel of each trade collector machine too. I've put plenty of info about how trade will all work in the video description. There's still a lot more to do to finish the trade system, from art to features, which I'll be working on in the next devlog. Before then though, make sure to wishlist the game on Steam. Wishlists help the game get featured on release and help me out a lot. You'll also get notified when the game comes out or goes on sale. Patreon is the best place to support the channel though, and you can check out the rewards at the link in the description. Thanks of course go to my patrons. In particular, I'd like to thank Nova, WarnerM14, Sheshpesh, Mike James, BD Smith, Mr. Smith, Ojo Marin, Pepper Trollman, Chris Naismith, Hayden, Kleb, Gecko, and HPR. That's all for this week. If you liked the video, make sure to subscribe for my future devlogs, and I shall see you next time. Cheers for watching.